let's take a look at how you can customize the look, feel, and function of the Infinium operating system. An important step in any experiment is to optimize your test equipment, if possible, to your personal preferences and workflow. Let's take a look at all of the ways Infinium lets you customize the GUI to match your preferences and needs in the lab. This is not an exhaustive list, as each individual feature or application may have deeper layers of personalization, but should apply to general purpose use of your oscilloscope. So let's begin. Let's jump into Setup, Display. The basics on the Window tab let you select how waveforms are laid out and how they should look after an autoscale. There are four basic ways to organize your waveforms, whether they be channel inputs, math functions, or otherwise. They can be overlaid onto a single grid, stacked on a single grid, separated vertically on independent grids, or tiled into a square pattern that's dependent on how many waveforms are active. You can also create separate tabs to organize things, with these layouts being contained within the tabs. You can also move entire tabs or grids to a separate floating window or drag them off screen. At the bottom, you can change the brightness of the waveform and the grid lines. In the Waveforms tab, you can control persistence, connect the dots mode for each source, and color grading. In the Appearance tab, you can switch the entire UI in and out of dark mode, or what we call the midnight theme. You can also make dialogues transparent, change the size of text, menus, and results, and a few other tweaks based on your preferences. Colors is a fun tab, because you can redefine the color of anything that you see on the display, from channels to the entire background of the grids. This is fantastic for users who are colorblind or for those who are just feeling kind of artistic. Inverting colors for the purposes of printing is located right in the print options, by the way. So there isn't a need to come into this menu every time you want a white background to save some ink. There are also some display options for your measurement results, on-screen callouts, and protocol decode results. A useful customization option many people aren't actually aware of is in the trigger menu. If you've spent some time setting up a complex trigger condition that you want to recall later, you can access that feature under Trigger, Save Load. There are 10 quick slots you can save to in a pinch or to a dedicated file. Quick slots are erased if you happen to do a factory reset at the scope, so be aware of that. This is also true of oscilloscope setup files, which save the state of the entire oscilloscope globally. The last customization area we'll explore is under Utilities, User Preferences. Here we can change technical preferences of the oscilloscope's operation. The autoscale mode of displayed channels only is useful if you have many channels connected, but only want autoscale to work on the channels you've manually enabled. With all channels selected, the scope will look at the input of every analog and digital channel and enable them if something's detected. This could be a time saver or an annoyance depending on how you use the oscilloscope, hence the option. Vertical scaling expansion lets you switch how the vertical scale acts when you zoom in. The difference is noticeable when you're on a zoomed in signal with an offset away from ground, as exemplified here. Auto power on will automatically turn the oscilloscope back on after a line power interruption. Factory default is one step past a default setup. It will completely wipe everything, including all of the customization settings we've discussed so far. So having a warning message is a good idea, unless you use factory default frequently. Default setup will only reset things related to measurements, triggers, and general signal acquisition while maintaining your user preferences. As you can see, Infinium provides a high level of customization based on your preferences and needs in the lab, and everything is just a few clicks away. Once you have your scope set up exactly as you'd like, don't forget to save a setup file for yourself in the file menu to recall later in case someone else does have the factory default. Finally, make sure to check out the rest of the series highlighting the new capabilities in our next generation platforms, linked in the description below.